I don't read as much as I used to, right? You know the old cult classics like The Hunger Games. The Hunger Games series to me was like my favorite thing in the world. People had their Harry Potters and their Divergents, but I had The Hunger Games. I was obsessed. I have all three books, like three separate times. I have the whole trilogy in three different copies, like the originals, the movie, and the hardcover. And I had the pins. I watched all the movies. I still have my tickets from going to watch the movies. I didn't end up watching Mockingjay 1 and 2 in theaters, and that makes me hurt beyond any kind of hurt that I could ever feel. But like March 23, the day the first movie came out, is ingrained into my soul. Anytime I see the date March 23rd, and this, let me remind you, The Hunger Games 1 came out like ages ago. But let me look at the year. Right now, it is 2019, and I will tell you when the first Hunger Games movie came out. Release. Let me see. It is 2019 right now, and the first Hunger Games movie came out March 23rd, 2012. 7 years ago. 7 years ago. I remember. It is ingrained into my heart and soul, the date March 23rd, for a movie that came out 7 freaking years ago. Can I do that? Is that the thing that people do? I don't know if that looks the same, but you know. Also, I made a TikTok. Look, I'm lame. But that movie came out freaking 7 years ago, March 23rd. Okay, so you know there's all those cult classics, like The Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark. There were those things that people were obsessed with. And I ended up watching, okay, if you watched The Hunger Games, the girl who played Rue in the first movie, Amanda Steinberg, I never pronounced that right. But first of all, I love her. She's amazing. And so I saw that she was starring in this movie called Darkest Minds. And the person who was playing the other guy in it looked like the guy from the Jurassic Park movies. Like the recent Jurassic Park movie, the handsome guy. But apparently this was based off books. And so, okay, first of all, you're gonna bear with me. I'm gonna make an anime reference for a second. The movie is, these people have eye powers, and there's like, I think it was 4 different colors. You can have like green, and green is like, you're really smart. You could have red, which is like really rare, and you're like, you're almost like overly powered, where you can like control people. And there's like, there's other colors. There's like 2 other colors, I think it was. And so the main character is Amanda Steinberg, the girl who played Rue. And so that was my first peak of interest. And then in the fact that like they have eye powers, I think it just excited me because I saw this one anime, or 2 animes actually. This one anime that was Mekaku City Actors, or Kagaru Days. They have eye powers. I think it just shows in their eyes. But they have eye powers. Super cool. It's a completely different execution than this book. And then the anime series, Charlotte, oh my gosh, that was really good. Both of them were really amazing. Totally worth looking at if you watch anime. But, so the story, the concept of it is they have eye powers or whatever. And so I watched this movie. I watched this movie with my sister, and we rented it on Redbox, right? Because we were like, oh, I heard about that movie. I saw it advertised, but like, you know, I didn't watch it in theaters. It was amazing. I don't go on about movies much because I normally do watch like animated, really weird, artsy movies that can't be executed the same as like live action movies. And this movie, the actors, oh my goodness, the actors did so good. So the main 2 characters, the main girl and the main guy, they have like such a charming, like wholesome, really, it really feels like it's their first crush, and they execute it so perfectly, even to the point where I was like, oh, like, I feel shy now, or like, oh, that's so cute, like, that's exactly the kind of nervous that you would be, and they depicted it so well. And so, fast forward in the story, you get into these really intense situations, and there's this huge plot twist about what happened, and because you were like, there's something that you wonder throughout the whole story, and you're like, what the heck, like, what happened? I don't really get what happened. Why was she taken away? And stuff like that. And so, like, it ends up being explained, and then there's still, like, a whole, like, 30-40 minutes left in the movie. And this is all based off the first book, right? And then, so, in the very end, so, spoilers, while I have my hands up, she ends up joining forces with the people who work for the government, kind of, and have eye powers, and they're, like, raising this whole army of people who have eye powers. And it's a really powerful thing. But Now, spoilers for the very end. The very end, what made me cry, I cried. Let me tell you, I have never cried this bad. I've cried really bad before. I guess now I have cried this bad in a certain situation. But before then, I had never cried. I cried like I lost just the closest person to me ever in the movie. Oh my goodness. At the very end, there's this beautiful sequence. Her and her crush have like this beautiful just interaction, and they're talking about how like envisioning a future and like, oh, I see you at the beach and you have this really big brim hat on, and like you can see, like you were looking out at the ocean, the waves are splashing, it's beautiful, and this and that, and they have this whole really like, it's the closure that you wanted, and then something happens, and that thing that happens, oh my goodness, I bawled so bad. Bawled in the sense that it was crippling to me. Like, I fell to the floor just crying and bawling, and like, I couldn't talk, I couldn't breathe. It was like the, like, that really intense, crazy crying, and I loved it. Not, like, and it, so, apparently this movie did bad in theaters. I feel bad now, too, because I didn't go watch it in theaters, so I couldn't support it even for that, like, $20 more that it could have gotten. But it kind of looks like it's not going to get a second movie, and that makes me sad. So I'm probably going to have to read the books, because, I mean, just the book, the first movie that I watched, it was more than enough to convince me to read the books. I'll probably read the books at some point in my life. I can't promise that I'll do it like this year, this week, or anything, because, I don't know, I have college and everything. But the movie was amazing. The actors did such an amazing job. The premise of the book in itself just looked amazing. I don't know, since I haven't read the books, I don't know if like the book story is completely different than the movie story, but just bear with me. Consider watching the movie, consider reading the books. It was amazing. It was beautiful. The very end, I don't know, maybe I'm just really sympathetic, or just like, maybe I don't know, I do cry to movies normally, like if they're good, you know, and this, I cried. I cry at movies, but I have never cried this freaking hard at a movie, okay? So I definitely think this was, like, really good. Like, and it only worked so well because all of the interactions that happened between the characters and how greatly they acted it out and played the parts. They were so convincing about all of it. So I think that was added a lot more potence to what happened in the end. But, oh my goodness, really, you have to watch it. You have to watch it to really understand, because it was crazy. I need to know that. It's not just me. Like, my sister and I, we both cried. Like, we yelled. We were like, no! When it happened, like, not like, I have to whisper right now, kind of, but like, we yelled no, and we cried and bawled, and you fell to the floor just crying and feeling for it. So I really think you should watch it. It was so good. Please watch Darkest Minds. It was so good. I'm gonna read the books. I'm gonna have to read the books if I wanna know what happens to the rest of the story, because I need to know what happens to the rest of the story, because this movie got me so invested in this whole concept and the whole story, and I need to watch it. Need to know what happened in the end. I need to read it. I definitely recommend you watch it if you haven't seen it. Read the book, or tell me about the books. Tell me about the books. I don't mind spoilers. I'll read them, I swear. But, I feel bad that I don't read as much as I used to, because I would have loved to find out about this and known about the book and read the book before the movie was even coming out. But, oh my goodness, I still recommend that everyone watch that movie. It was amazing. Watch The Darkest Minds. I think it'll make you feel so many things. I think it's definitely worth a shot. Please give it a look.